Hello everyone and welcome into today's PCB webinar. My name is Xim and I am the account manager for security portfolio at PCB, also the organizer of this webinar. I believe you all know that PCB organizes daily webinars in our 5 portfolios, and every week we organize a webinar on the security portfolio covering different topics and areas. In this 30-minute webinar, we will hear about the topic information security between best practices and ISO standards. This webinar will be presented by Mr. Mohamed Gohar, who has more than 10 years of experience in ISM, ITSM training and consulting. He is one of the expert reviewers of CISA RM 26th edition, ISM senior trainer consultant at Edgebyte. I hope you will enjoy this webinar and find it very informative. If you have any question, you can write them in question box in right-hand control panel, or you can use the option to raise your hand and we will answer to all of them accordingly. Please, Mohamed, you may continue.
Okay, thank you, Gizem. It's my pleasure to be with all of you today. I hope you will find this webinar beneficial for you. Well, I think we have a busy agenda for this session. Hopefully, we will successfully go through it in the allotted time. In our webinar today, we are going to cover the following points in a nutshell. Information security best practices like enterprise security architecture frameworks, for instance, open enterprise security architecture and Sherwood applied business security architecture, COVID or control objectives for information and related technology. Some people call it control objectives for business and related technology. Overview. IT Infrastructure Library, or ITIL, and Axelos Resilient, which is a new cyber resilience framework. In addition, we will have a look on some publications of NIST, the National Institute of Standards and Technology, like framework for improving critical infrastructure cybersecurity. Then we will have a brief look on ISO standards for information security, like ISO 27000 series. Finally, we will conclude our session for today by trying to answer the important question after our journey through the information security best practices and the ISO standards. That is, what is best for me as an organization, corporate or business? Information security best practices or ISO standards for information security? Okay, governance deals with two important aspects. These are enterprise risk management and the internal controls of the organization. Information security governance is derived from the corporate governance, and it is parallel to or sometimes a subset from the governance of enterprise IT. In simple words, information security governance is used to direct and control the information security of the organization. It is useful at this point to differentiate between the information security governance and the information security management. The main difference between them is that information security governance, for instance, defines the accountability, which can neither be delegated nor transferred to a third party, and defines the strategic planning of the information security. While on the other hand, information security management, and as an example, defines the responsibility which can be delegated and transferred to a third party, and it defines the project planning of the information security. So concisely, information security governance is about doing the right things, while information security management is about doing things right. NIST defines IT governance as a framework to provide assurance that information security strategies are aligned with business objectives through proper policies, internal controls, roles and responsibilities to better manage risk. It goes without saying that top management commitment is crucial to succeed the governance objectives. General governance areas are as following. One, govern the operations and protect the critical assets of the organization, two, protect the organization's market share and stock price, three, govern the conduct of employees at work by developing the right policies, four, protect the reputation and the image of the organization, five, ensure compliance requirements are met by conducting periodic audits. An important quote to conclude with: governing for enterprise security means viewing adequate security as a non-negotiable requirement for being in business. COVID or control objectives for information and related technology is a framework created by ISACA for information technology management and information technology governance. COVID-5 process model includes 37 governance and management processes, 5 processes for governance, and 32 processes for management. Governance main objectives are benefits realization, number one, to realize benefits as a return on investment on IT projects, two, risk optimization, to manage the organization's risk profile in a proper way, three, resource optimization, using the available resources effectively and efficiently. COVID-5 for information security is one of the COVID-5 professional guides. COVID-5 for information security builds on COVID-5 framework in that it focuses on information security and provides more detailed and more practical guidance for information security professionals and other interested parties at all levels of the enterprise. COVID-5, as you can see in this figure, separates governance from management and makes a clear distinction between governance and management, because governance and management encompass different types of activities and require different organizational structures and serve different purposes. COVID-5 for information security aligns COVID with ISO 38500, ISO standard, which is for governance of IT for the organization. Also, it aligns COVID with ISO 27000 series that are dedicated for information security. COVID-5 for information security pays attention not only to processes but also to all information structures, culture, policies, and their interdependence. Here is a list of some good publications on information security governance frameworks from the IT Governance Institute, or ITGI for short. Information Security Governance Guidance for Board of Directors and Executive Management. Information Security Governance Guidance for Information Security Managers. COVID-5 for Information Security. Now we will talk about the Enterprise Security Architecture frameworks. We will have a look on the Oven Group Enterprise Security Architecture. The road to information security goes through corporate governance. There should be a linkage between governance and the security architecture. This link is established through policies. The functions of the Oven Enterprise Security Architecture are as following: governance, number one, like policies, standards, and auditing; number two, technology architecture, design and implement and the development and the physical architecture of systems; three, security operations, like administration, event and incident management. Objectives of Open Enterprise Security Architecture are as following: preserving the CIA triad, which is confidentiality, integrity, and availability, number one. Number two, effective information security through accountability and assurance, customer satisfaction through fulfilling the security demands. Sure, with Applied Business Security Architecture, or SABSA, is a methodology for enterprise security and the service management. It is widely used to fulfill a variety of needs, including risk management, information assurance, governance, and the continuity management. SABSA key benefits are as following. It ensures that the needs of the enterprise are met and that security services are designed, delivered, and supported as part of the business and the enterprise security architecture is used to develop and implement security strategies, important function. Also, enterprise security architecture or enterprise information security architecture, if it is part of the enterprise architecture or EA, can be effective to ensure proper controls are implemented and integrated throughout the organization infrastructure, processes, and the technologies. The SABSA model covers the whole life cycle of operational capabilities, that is strategy and planning as a first phase, design as a second phase, implement as a third phase, finally manage and measure as a fourth phase, and comprises, as you can see, six layers. For each horizontal layer, there is also a vertical analysis based on the six questions or primitive interrogatives. What, assets, why, motivation, how, process and the technology, who, people, where, location, when, time. This leads to a 6x6 cell matrix called the SBSA master matrix, as you can see in the figure. The sixth layer, the service of management or operational layer, can be overlaid on the other five layers and further vertically to produce the 5x6 cell SABSA service management matrix. ITIL is the best framework for IT service management. It is directed by policies, organized and structured in processes and supporting procedures. Here are some quick facts about ITIL. ITIL 2011 is the current framework. ITIL has five stages. The life cycle of ITIL has five stages: service strategy, service design, service transition, service operation, and continual service improvement. ITIL includes 26 processes and ITIL functions are service desk, technical management, operation management, and finally application management. Information security is one of the ITIL processes and it resides in design stage of the ITIL life cycle. According to ITIL, information security is part of the corporate governance and it directs the security activities strategically to ensure security and hence business objectives are achieved. Information security deals with security risks to manage them properly, to identify number one, then analyze number two, evaluate number three, and treat risks professionally number four. Information security preserves the CIA confidentiality, integrity, availability trial to protect the organization's assets. We need to have the right security policies in place along with the management to succeed information security and to achieve its objectives. The shown flow diagram of the information security process in ITIL 2011 depicts that it all starts with information security policy and the management commitment on top of that for sure. Then assessment and categorization of information assets and risks and doing that periodically. You have to put to the proper security controls as mitigation measures. Then you need to monitor and manage security incidents and to report and review that on a regular basis. All these activities should be served by Security Management Information System or SMIS that is maintained by the organization. That SMIS contains information security policy, security reports, security controls, security risks and responses. Resilia is a cyber resilience framework developed by Axios. The unique thing about Resilia is that it offers practical knowledge to enhance existing management strategies and align cyber resilience with IT operations, security and incident management. Resilia uses the IT lifecycle to develop the skills and the insight needed to detect, respond to and recover from cyber attacks. In my opinion, Resilia offers two good things. First one, enhancement to the IT part related to information security. Number two, care about after the fact and business continuity beyond security incidents. Cyber resilience definition is the ability of a system to resist a sudden disturbance or failure and to recover in a timely manner following any disturbance or failure. While cybersecurity definition is the state of being free from danger or threat. Cybersecurity focuses more on prevention and less on recovery from incidents. NIST publications are usually used by federal agencies or governmental organizations and can be used also by non-governmental organizations. NIST is responsible for developing the standards and the guidelines, including minimum requirements, and for providing adequate information security for all agency operations and assets. We have NIST 800-100, which is Information Security Handbook, a guide for managers. This guide covers topics like information security governance, risk management, and incident response. We have also framework, another guide, framework for improving critical infrastructure cybersecurity. This guide considers cybersecurity risks as part of the organization's risk management processes. This framework consists of three parts. The framework core, number one, the framework profile, number two, and the framework tiers, number three. Each part has a certain function. For instance, through use of the profiles, the framework will help the organization align its cybersecurity activities with its business requirements, risk tolerances, and resources. NIST 800-53 Revision 4. This guide for security and the privacy controls for federal information systems and organizations. This publication provides a catalog of security and the privacy controls for federal information systems and organizations and a process for selecting controls to protect organizational operations and organizational assets from a diverse set of threats, including hostile cyber attacks, natural disasters, and human errors. It includes 285 controls and 19 family of controls. The controls are customizable and implemented as part of an organization-wide process that manages information security and privacy risk. ISO standards for information security. As we have seen, there is a strong link between governance and information security. So we introduce here the following ISO standard, ISO 38500 for the year 2015, which provides guiding principles, members of governing bodies of organizations on the effective, efficient, and acceptable use of information technology within their organizations. It also provides guidance to those advising, informing, or assisting governing bodies. They include the following: 1, executive managers; 2, members who monitor the resources of the organization; 3, external business or technical specialists, such as legal or accounting specialists or professional bodies; then internal and external service providers; and finally, auditors. ISO 38500, its main purpose is to promote effective, efficient, and acceptable use of IT in all organizations, assuring stakeholders that if the principles and the practices proposed by the standard are followed, they can have confidence in the organization's governance of IT. Then ISO 20000 Part 1 for year 2011 is a service management system, or SMS, standard. It specifies requirements for the service provider to plan, establish, and maintain and improve an SMS. The requirements include the design, delivery, and the continual improvement of services to fulfill agreed service requirements. ISO 20000 Part 1 for the year 2011 can be used by many parties. For instance, an organization seeking services from service providers and requiring assurance that their service requirements will be fulfilled. The service provider said that intends to demonstrate its capability for the design, delivery, and the continual improvement of services that fulfill service requirements. An assessor, or as a criteria for a conformity assessment of a service provider's SMS to the requirements in ISO 20000 Part 1 for year 2011. ISO 20000 standard includes 13 processes and 4 process groups. These are service delivery, relationship, resolution, and control. One of the 13 processes is the information security management process that lies within the service delivery process group. The information security, or ISM, process should ensure that security controls are in place to protect information assets and that information security requirements are reflected on the design and the transition of new or changed services. Also, it deals with issues like information security policy, information security controls, managing information security risks, and information security changes and incidents. We can see in the figure the 4 process groups of ISO 20000. Service delivery, one group; relationship, another group; resolution, third group; and the control, fourth group. And that the information security management process is part of the service delivery process group. Like ITIL, ISO 20000 does not focus primarily on IT service, does focus primarily on management and does not give much attention to information security. This is why, in my opinion, Axelus filled in the gap by developing resilience. ISO 27001, Information Security Management Systems. ISO 27000 family of standards helps organizations keep information assets secure. Using this family of standards will help your organization manage the security of assets, such as financial information, intellectual property, and employee details. ISO 27001 for year 2013 is the best known standard in the family, providing requirement information security management system, or ISMS. This international standard specifies the requirements or shells for establishing, maintaining, and continually improving an information security management system within the context of the organization. It consists of 114 controls, 14 groups of controls, and 35 control objectives. ISO 27002 for year 2013 Code of Practice for Information Security Controls. This international standard gives guidelines or shoulds for organizational information security standards and information security management practices to better select, implement, and manage the security controls, taking into consideration the organization's information security risk environments. It is designed and used by organizations that intend to select controls within the process of implementing an information security management system or ISMS based on ISO 27001 via a statement of applicability. ISO 27005 for year 2011 Information Security Risk Management. It supports the general concepts specified in ISO 27001 and is designed to assist the satisfactory implementation of information security based on a risk management approach. Both of ISO 27001 and ISO 27002 are important for a complete understanding of ISO 27005 for year 2011. ISO 27005 for year 2011 is applicable to all types of organizations, commercial, government organizations, which intend to manage comprise the organization's information security. ISO 27034, Part 1 for year 2011, Application Security Overview and Concepts, provides guidance to assist organizations in integrating security into the managing processes of their applications. ISO 27034, Part 1 for year 2011, presents an overview of application security. It introduces definitions, concepts, principles, and the processes involved in application security. ISO 27034 is applicable to in-house developed applications, number one, acquired third-party applications, number two, and the outsourced applications in either development or operations, number three. ISO 27034, Part 2 for year 2015, Application Security Organization Normative Framework, ONF, provides guidance to organizations for the implementation of the Organization Normative Framework, the or ONF. The ONF is an organization-wide framework where all application security best practices recognized by the organization are stored. Now let us conclude what we have been through in this session and let us try to answer the question, what is best for me as an organization, corporate or business? Information security best practices or ISO standards for information security. The conclusion, whenever it is applicable, start with governance of enterprise IT and cascade down to other lower levels like information security management or IT service management. Governance of enterprise IT is a subset of corporate governance. Also, policy is a linkage between governance and enterprise security architecture or enterprise information security architecture. Enterprise security architecture or enterprise information security architecture is an integral part of enterprise architecture. The main objectives or objective of governance of enterprise IT, enterprise architecture, enterprise security architecture, enterprise information security architecture, IT service management, information security management, is to strategically align the business objectives with the enterprise IT objectives. Policies define the necessary standards to implement and comply with. Information security management and IT service management best practices frameworks are important steps to successfully implement ISO standards. Generally, ISO standards are auditable. You can audit against them, while best practices frameworks are not auditable. Solid business case should be developed to adapt any best practices framework and or standards. The meaning is that do not just do it because others do it. You have to have a solid business case. Cybersecurity is more than just protecting information assets. It cares about after the fact and the business continuity beyond security incidents. Auditing is a governance powerful tool to enforce compliance with policies and standards. And finally, recommendation. For sure, it all depends on the maturity level of your environment. But as a general rule, the good practice is first apply the relevant best practice framework, then go for the related ISO standard. For instance, implement ITIL framework, which is the best framework for IT service management, then go for ISO 20000, which is dedicated for IT service management. Another example, implement Resilia or any other best practice for information security or information security management system, don't go for ISO 27001. And thank you.
Thank you, Mohamed, for your presentation. We have a few questions. I will read them and you will be able to answer. The first question is, NIST cybersecurity framework, as stated in the publication, is voluntary. As such, it does not place regulatory requirements. From your experience and knowledge, what are the regulatory requirements to be implemented regarding this matter?
Actually, as the best practices from NIST or ISACA or Axios or all these vendors are not mandatory. So you have the freedom to adapt and adopt whatever suits your environment. So there are no specific regulations you have to comply with to implement such best practice frameworks. I hope I answered the question.
Okay. The second question by the same person is, how about auditing against COVID?
Auditing, as we have said, first of all, COVID is, again, a best practice. It is not an auditable framework. So, as a general rule, the auditing is a powerful tool for any governance framework to use to be sure that you comply and you comply with standards you choose to adapt or adopt. So, you don't audit against COVID because COVID in general is not an auditable framework. But, however, auditing is a powerful tool to be sure that you implement the how you achieve the governance objectives in a right way. Okay,
this last question is there any sort of assessment that gives the indication of a level of alignment between standards on the organization?
Yes, you have tools in the governance scorecards, and you have performance management tools, business scorecards, and you have many tools to be sure that the business objectives are aligned in a good way with the objectives of enterprise IT, like business scorecard. Okay.
Okay, thank you, Mohamed, for giving us this highly informative presentation. I believe the attendees had the chance to learn many new things today, and I suggest you to take time and see our future webinar that we will be hosting. Next Wednesday, we will host a webinar topic which is called Vulnerability Assessment and Penetration Testing in Online SCADA, ICS Environment, Risk Methods and Recommended Practices. You can also take time and visit our website www.pcb.com on the webinar section to register for our future webinars. Thank you once again and hope to meet you soon in our future webinars.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.